Yo, what's going on, guys? It's the Beast Pokeballer here, as always, coming at you guys with a new series coming to the channel, which is going to be themed Wi-Fi battles. In this, I'm going to take your guys' suggestion from the comments, and I'm going to go into Wi-Fi battles on Pokemon Rated Battle Spot, and we're going to just bring our themed battles. Now, for the pilot episode, we're doing something a little bit different. As you guys probably definitely already know, Pokemon Sun and Moon were actually just announced as the new next Pokemon games. So today, guys, I have Pokemon Sun and Moon themed teams. So we're going to be doing three battles with each team, or best two out of three with each team. If we win the first two, then we'll go on to a third. If we win the first two, then we're done. If we lose the first two, then we're done. It's basically just two out of three, you know. So we're going to have a maximum of six battles today, minimum of four. And yeah, I'm going to go over the teams real quick. So here we go. Alright guys, starting us out with the Sun team, of course. We have Solrock. Like, what else? What else would it be other than Solrock? Next up, we have our Mega, which is going to be Mega Charizard Y. It just makes sense. It's bringing the Sun. We have Heliolisk. Evolves with the Sunstone. It's like a lizard that lays out in the Sun. Espeon, which I believe represents the Sun, and Umbreon represents the Moon. We'll get to that later, of course. We have Ninetales, again, also brings the Heat with that Drought ability, making the Sunshine. And then we have Venusaur with its Chlorophyll ability, which, you know, obviously it takes from the Sun. So, that is the Sun-themed team. Next, we'll go ahead and go through the Moon-themed team. So here we go. And of course, guys, what Moon-themed team would not start off with Lunatone? Lunatone, of course. Alongside that, we have Umbreon, of course, to, you know, Sun, Moon, Sun, Espeon, Moon, Umbreon. Next up, we have Nidoking evolves with a Moonstone. We have Weavile. Weavile just reminds me of the Night, and, you know, obviously the Night, Moon, makes sense, right? We have Nidoqueen, you know, Nidoking and Nidoqueen both evolve with Moonstones. And then, weird enough, we have Salamence. When it Mega evolves, its thing looks like a Crescent Moon, you know? So we have Mega Salamence on our side, which is going to help us a lot, and I'm really excited, guys, so we're going to be starting out with the Sun team. We're going to do the best two out of three with that. And then we're going to move on to the Moon team. Now, remember, guys, I would really enjoy it if you put your suggestions for teams, different themes of teams. And you can even put the Pokemon you want and the sets even if you want. And we're going to use one of those in the next episode. And, guys, if you really want to support this new series, you know, I don't know if I'm going to be carrying it for that long. Depends how well it does. Depends if you guys like it. So if you do like it, feel free to leave that like, guys. That would help me out so much. There's no layout yet. No layout or thumbnails, like special thumbnail yet. That's because I don't want to spend the money on a series that doesn't do well. So we're going to wait and see how it does first. And then, after that, I'll go ahead and spend the money, get, like, the thumbnails and everything made. So, guys, without that, let's go ahead and jump into Battle Spot. All right, guys, here we go. And we're going to go ahead and challenge the battle spot right now. Okay, wait, we got to change to music 21 real quick. We got to, right? Come on, let's get there. Let's get there. There you go, music 21. As you can see, we're starting out with the Sun team, as I said before. We're just looking for a partner right now. Our record is nice and 1,500 at the moment. And we have nice Osaka? Japan, Osaka. Okay. So he's going to be rocking the Porygon 2, Blaziken, Mega Blaziken probably. It's probably a Mega Blaziken and a Mega. Oh god, this team is actually pretty threatening. Now, I think for us, the best thing to start off with is going to be our, isn't everything that's going to set up rock, so Espeon wouldn't be the greatest lead. In fact, Espeon doesn't really touch much on this team. So why don't we bring, what hits this team the hardest? I think Charizard can hit pretty hard, right? So we'll bring Charizard, we'll bring Venusaur, of course. What can stop the Talonflame? How about we bring Solrock, okay? This seems like a pretty good thing. Charizard, Venusaur. Do we even really want the Venusaur? Maybe Heliolisk will do better. Nah, let's go Venusaur, guys. Let's go straight into it. Let's go straight into it and see how we do in this battle. This is rated single battle spot, by the way, if I have not said that yet. So that's pretty awesome. It's pretty awesome. What do you have for us? What do you have for us, Mr. Japanese name? What do you got? Alright, we're going to send our Charizard, our Mega Charizard, little does he know. And he's going to be sending out something Japanese, which is going to be the Mega Kangaskhan. That's already scary, guys. That is already scary. But what I'm going to do is Mega Evolve, and I'm going to nice and throw out that Flamethrower and just do some massive damage. He's probably going to do the little Kling Kling fake out and whatnot. So we'll see what we can do. We'll see what we can do to him. Mega Kangaskhans, I can tell, are going to be all over Battle Spot in this series. That's okay. That's okay. Alrighty. Drought. Alright, yep, there we go. Getting our Sun up for the Sun theme team. Are you guys hyped for Pokemon Sun and Moon, by the way? I sure know I am. I'm, like, so excited. I'm making a ton of videos about it, because that's how excited and passionate I am about it. Really, guys, I am. Remember to hit that sub button if you're not subscribed already, guys. That will help me out a ton. And we just get the straight-up Flamethrower out. He doesn't go for the fake out. Can we get a burn? He's going for the Ice Punch. That's weird. Predicting the other form of Charizard, I'd assume. So that's good for us. It's going to hit twice, which is going to do over half, which is really scary. But I know that's enough for us to go ahead and take him out here with a second. Do we want to go for like a Solar Beam or something just in case? I don't know. Let's go for a Solar Beam. Maybe he'll switch. Maybe he'll try and predict it. Nope, he's going to go for Sucker Punch. Oh, no. Are we dead? That's the question. Oh, no. I think we are. Oh, that sucks. That's okay, though. We can send in our Venusaur now, which I know will do a ton of work to this thing. Should be able to take it out. Alright, Venusaur, let's go. I'm surprised that he went for the Ice Punch. That was really weird. I don't know why he did that. But it's fine by me, man. I'll take it. Anyways, we can definitely outspeed here, so let's just go for the Giga Drain. He's probably going to Sucker Punch. No, we outspeed. I guess he didn't expect us to be faster, but of course with the Sun, we are indeed faster, which is awesome. But yeah, if you guys do enjoy the series and want to see an episode 2, probably gonna have an episode weekly. If you guys do want to see an episode 2, definitely hit me up in the comment section. Tell me the teams that you want, leaving the like. It will all be really helpful, guys. So, I'm going to go ahead and Sleep Powder. I know this thing is now fast because of the Sun, which is not good. But I don't think it can take us out in one hit, and we still outspeed. Getting that Sleep Powder off, putting this thing to bed, guys. This thing is now asleep completely. Which is good for us, 100%. Now we can start hitting this thing really hard with some sludge bombs, doing some good damage. Which is just what I plan on doing, really, it is. Just gonna hit with a sludge bomb. Of course, we're very bulky ourselves, so that's good. The sludge bomb should do pretty okay damage, not the best in the world. Luckily, he is asleep. The recover is gonna be quite annoying, though, once he finally wakes up. The Sun is actually gone. I don't think that changes much at this point in the battle, where he has an asleep Porygon, and I have a Venusaur. Plus, he has the Chlorophyll ability, which isn't going to do anything for him at the moment, as long as the Sun's gone too. Now, all we need is one more turn for him to stay asleep. We just need one more turn, and this Porygon is out of here. It is gone. It is dead to me. Come on, Porygon. Stay asleep. Come on, have them dreams. Tell me you're dreaming. Tell me you're dreaming. Oh, it wakes up, and it's going to go for the Ice Beam. Now, I don't think that's actually going to kill. I think it's going to do, like, good damage, but, yeah, even it didn't really do good damage at all. Plus, our Black Sludge is going to do enough to heal us up a little bit. And we can just go ahead and go for another Sludge Bomb. That's a dead Porygon too. That is a dead Porygon too. Oh, he's gonna pull the switch into the Aegislash, right? The Aegislash, yeah. Luckily for us, we can put this thing to sleep real quick. We can just put this thing to sleep. It does nothing to us. It ain't doing anything. Not a thing. Go for that Sleep Powder. I think this thing might be really hard to take out though. I don't know how we're gonna be able to take it out. So that's kind of scary. He's now asleep, that's awesome. We're gonna have to switch into Solrock. He's gonna do a stance change. What's the stance change up? Giga Drain will probably do an okay amount of damage. I don't know, let's see. Let's find out. We will go for a Giga Drain here. We'll see what it does while he's in attack mode. That's gonna do good damage. It's gonna do very good damage. That's awesome. Cool. So we can actually just keep on firing these out while he's asleep, which is gonna help us a lot. I don't think Solrock can really touch this thing too well. We might already have the battle in the bag, guys. We might already have the battle in the bag. So that's awesome. Yeah, what's he gonna do? What are you gonna do, dude? I don't think he can do much to us at this point. We can always just put him back to sleep if worse comes to worse, really. We can just keep throwing these at him. Giga Drain coming out. As long as he's not smart enough to switch into, like, defensive mode, which doesn't seem like he's smart enough. His rating is pretty low, so, yeah. Unfortunately, it's not going to be another 2-8 KO, because he does have the leftovers, which kind of sucks. I have a feeling he might wake up this turn. I don't know. Another Giga Drain's going to go off doing a ton of damage. Nice. Good job, Venusaur. You're doing good, man. He's going to wake up this turn, and he's going to go for an Iron Head. Doesn't bother me at all. Like, it does, yeah, a ton of damage. But of course, we're going for the Giga Drains, and I can just put him back to sleep real quick, once again, you know? He can just go right back to sleep, and we can just finish him off with a few more. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go for another Sleep Powder. Hopefully it won't miss. If it misses, that might screw us over. And it misses, and that screws us over. Are we gonna be dead? Aw, come on, Venusaur. Ah, Venusaur did so well. But that's alright, Venusaur. He's gonna take his leftover recoveries, and of course, we have the Sun back in action, guys. We have the OG Sun. We have Solrock. Now, I don't know exactly what Solrock can do, and I know this thing probably has Shadow Sneak, so the battle's most likely over. Little does he know that I have Will-O-Wisp. Oh, he's getting on the stance change, which means Will-O-Wisp can go right through that. Will-O-Wisp can go right through that King Shield. So, ooh, sorry, dude. Sorry, if you weren't ready to fight the sun, you shouldn't have tried, man. There we go. Solrock putting in the work, guys. Solrock is definitely putting in the work here. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Awesome. He's gonna restore a little with leftovers, but yeah, I mean, he's gonna lose all that to the burn damage, unfortunately for him. Which means I can set up some cosmic powers. Is that something I want to do, or I just want to go for Rock Slide? I'm gonna set up some cosmic powers. He's gonna stay into defense mode, which means he didn't go for Shadow Sneak. Which means he went for that Iron Head again, right? Yeah. I don't think this is gonna do much at all, despite being super effective. Yeah, nothing. There we go. Good job, dude. Solrock is actually coming in really handy. I didn't expect that at all. Like, at all. But yeah, remember, guys, just, I know I keep saying this, but remember to leave your suggestions for my next team in the comments below for next week. This should be a weekly series, like I said. We're not going to be using two teams every week, but it's just for the special pilot episode, I thought we would. And I thought, you know, I thought that was a pretty good idea. So we're going to go ahead and throw out another Rock Slide. This might be enough to take him out. Kind of doubt it. Oh, so close, so close. He's going for the Iron Head, ain't going to do nothing at all. And he gets a critical hit, and it's going to do a ton to us. Of course, right? Of course, my luck, right? He deserved that critical hit. Uh-huh, right? Well, at least I think the burn damage will take him down. Hopefully. Ah, that hacks right there. That's okay, guys. Hacks happens. You know, I'm not very salty. I'm not a very salty battler. I just like to play Pokemon, have fun, and entertain you guys. So that's what I'm trying to do today with this Pokemon Sun and Moon themed team. Alright. He's gonna trace our Levitate. That means nothing to me. The question is he faster and can he one-hit kill us? Let's find out. We're gonna outspeed and he's gonna avoid the tag. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? You're gonna give him that kind of hacks, really? You're gonna let him get a critical hit and then avoid it? Oh well. Whatever, I'll take it. You know, we might lose this battle. It's kind of looking not on our side at this point at all, really. We're just gonna have to get lucky with flinches. That's really the only way I see it happening. Because, you know, Solrock obviously isn't the world's greatest physical attacking Pokemon. Yeah, it's gonna do almost nothing. He's gonna go for a discharge, and I think that's gonna be the battle. No, it's not. We're gonna live that quite nicely, actually. Might even be able to take another one. Let's see how it goes. Go ahead, throw off another Rock Slide at him. What you gonna do? Get the flinch, maybe? Flinch, nice, we get the flinch. We just need a critical hit, guys. We need a critical hit and a flinch. Now he can definitely live another discharge. Except unless he gets another crit, which he probably will, considering all the hacks he's getting right now. But it's okay, guys. It is okay. We're gonna throw off that Rock Slide, and it's gonna do okay damage, still. We're gonna get the flinch twice in a row. Look at our hacks. The hacks has just turned around. I feel bad for this dude. If we get another, I'd feel kind of bad if we get another flinch right here. I would feel kind of bad. What's gonna happen? What's gonna happen to this little duck looking? We get the critical hit! And he's gonna go for the recovery, of course. But the good news is that we keep getting our leftovers back, so that's nice. Bing, bing, bing. Alright. And now what we can do is... I don't know, I guess we have to keep going for the Rock Slides, really. Just try and get lucky. Don't miss. Nice. I can't believe we got that critical hit there. That was insane. If it flinched, I would have freaked out. Oh my god, I feel so bad. We keep getting the flinches. I bet this guy's kind of upset, which makes me kind of upset. You know, I don't want to be that kind of player. But at the same time, you know, it's a game. It's just random number generated. That gives us these hacks. Those flinches were amazing. He's going to go for the discharge. Not going to be able to take us out. Unless he gets a critical hit himself, which he's not going to. Should be able to live another one, definitely. Alright, let's see if the hacks got... Let's see if Young Mo is on our side today, guys. We'll go for another Rock Slide. We only have 8 left. We only have 8 left. I believe we need probably like 4 to take him out at this point. Maybe less. We're going to get the flinch. There we go. Step 1. Step 1, guys. Alright, I feel kind of bad, this is kind of hacksy, and it's dragging on, I'm sure you guys don't find it the most entertaining thing in the world. But we'll try. Let's see, what's he gonna do? He's gonna go for the discharge again, of course we're gonna be able to live that. I think he's gonna recover this turn. We need to flinch him. We need to flinch him this turn. We need to not miss when we need to flinch, guys. Can we get this miracle to happen? Can we take him out? Let's find out. Can we do it? Come on, Solrock. You have to come in for Pokemon Sun. You have to come in. Come through. Oh! Flinch! We got the flinch! No way! That is insane. I feel actually insanely bad. But I shouldn't say it's over yet. We could miss. And I'm kind of feeling like we're gonna miss. But hopefully we don't, guys. Hopefully we can take him out. And we make the connection. Is that GG? That is GG, my friend. I can't believe that Solrock just put in that much work, guys. I cannot believe that Solrock just put in that much work. So that's going to be the first battle, guys. I'll see you back in just 1 second for the next battle. Alright, guys, we're back at it again. Trying to find our next battle with the Sun team. If we win, we're going to move on to the Moon team. If we lose, we're going to do one more battle with the Sun team and see how it goes. We have a 599 rating from Japan again. That's okay. I think we can take him. He's got a nice team. He's got some fire types. He also has Greninja, Mega Kangaskhan. He has his own Espeon. That's funny. So the question is, what is he going to start with? I want to bring Charizard again. Do I want to leave with Charizard? I do not know. Okay, let's leave with Charizard. In the back, we'll bring... I feel like Solrock will help again with the Rock Slide. We'll bring Solrock. And then what do we want to bring? What is it? Espeon can, like, take out the Blaziken, but then again, so can the Charizard easily. Espeon doesn't help too much. Heliolisk. Heliolisk can help against the Greninja. We already have the fire type for the Klefki's. Let's bring Heliolisk. I think that's our best bet. Or maybe Venusaur. I don't want to bring the same team twice, though. It's kind of lame. We will bring Heliolisk and see how it goes. Still waiting for this guy to pick. Hopefully he's not going to be a time-stalling guy. If he is, I will see you guys as soon as the clock hits one. But if not, hi, how you doing? But yeah, I hope your guys' day is actually going fantastic. I had a pretty good day myself, you know. Alright, here we go. Nice. He's got his three Pokemon. We got our three Pokemon. What's he going to throw out? What is he going to throw out today? He's got himself a... Alright, are we going to throw out? No, he's going to throw out first. He's got himself a Klefki, and we can take that down so easily with Charizard. Of course, what we have is Charizard. He might go for the Swagger. That would be pretty smart, not going to lie. But I see no reason not to just go for the Flamethrower. Not going to make any hardcore predictions. Going for that Solar Beam. If he wants to go into his Arcanine, if he wants to go into his Blaziken, feel free to go into your Arcanine or Blaziken, dude. I will Air Slash the hell out of them. And remember, guys, if you're enjoying the series, remember to hit that sub button and that like button for me. That'd be awesome, guys. Awesome. Yeah, I really want to get a layout. I was going to try and make my own, but I remembered I kind of suck at making layouts at the moment. So I didn't want it to look bad. I'd rather have it full screen than have a bad layout. He's going to go for the light screen, which, you know, that's going to help him for sure. But at the same time, like, we have such a high special attack. I'm not even worried. It's going to almost take him out. What I want to do here is... I think we should just take him out. Yeah. It does kind of suck that he has the screen up. I should have predicted it, and he goes for the Thunder Wave. Oh no, Charizard, your speed. Ah, that's a mess right there. We're paralyzed, and we can't move. We get paralyzed turn one, really? Ooh, the hacks are bad. But that's okay. We'll go ahead and we'll send out another Flamethrower. We should be able to take him out this time. I feel like we're... No, he's fast. No, well, he has Prankster. I think I'm for the Reflect. Smart, dude. That's smart. Get paralyzed again. Dang, the hacks in this episode are insane. I love it. I love hacks. It's funny as hell. We'll just go ahead and throw out another Flamethrower. See if we can get him this time, hopefully. He's going for the foul play. He didn't even swagger. I guess he doesn't have swagger. You get paralyzed three turns in a row. You're kidding me. Oh, well. We'll just go ahead and hit him up one last time. Maybe this will hit him. Maybe. Foul play's going to go off. Ugh. I mean, it's fair enough. We got all those flinches last time. I can't even complain about getting paralyzed three in a row. I shouldn't. Alright, we're going to get the super effective damage off on him. I kind of want to save the Charizard for the Sun, but actually the Sun doesn't really help us. Okay, it's gone. What's he going to go into? What are you going to go into, dude? I want to see what you go into. He's going to go into his Blaziken. Oop, my Stylus. Oh no, okay, I'll get him in a second. I'll go for the Air Slash. Maybe he'll try and set up Protect on us. Maybe Stone Edge will miss. Who knows? He's going to go for the Protect. I should have gone for Roost, really. Should have expected that, but it's okay. Yep, his speed's going to be raised, definitely. I hope he doesn't have Rock Slide. That would kind of rain on my parade. We'll go for Air Slash again. See if we can take him out this time. Let's see. We do have some powerful Pokemon in the past. He's going to go for Baton Pass. Now, what's he going to go into? That's what I want to know. The Arcanine? The Greninja? The Espeon. That's a weird thing to go into. I'm not going to lie. Espeon was definitely a weird choice for him. Anyways, I'm just going to Flamethrower. He's going to start setting up Calm Minds. Ooh, that is really scary, actually. That's really scary. Our Flamethrower is going to go off, though. I think it's going to do some good damage. It's going to do nothing at all, but we get to burn. There's Iron Hacks. There's Iron Hacks right there. So that definitely helps out a ton. Their Light Screen is gone, too, which is going to help, too. Is he going to set up another one? I know a Flamethrower will do a ton of damage if we get the crit. I don't think we're going to get the crit, but if we do, it'll do an amazing amount of damage, so that'd be pretty cool. Special Defense Rose. Ooh, that's scary. We're going to use our Flamethrower. Is it going to get the crit? Did we just get a crit, or was that raw damage? What the? That did so much! That did more than the first one by a ton, and that was after a second Calm Mind? I will take it. Does this thing get, like, Morning Sun? Yeah, that's what I thought. Even then, still, we can hit it pretty hard. The burn's not helping it at all, I know that's for sure. Flamethrower's gonna go off, gonna do a ton to him, like before. Nice, taking him down a good amount. He's gonna have to go for Morning Sun again, I believe. His Reflect is gone too, which means our Solarox Rock Slide will help. Alright, what are you gonna do? He's gonna go for Morning Sun again. He's just waiting for us to get paralyzed at this point. We might get a crit before we get paralyzed, though. Just saying, if we're lucky, we're gonna hit off our Flamethrower again. Insane. That one does almost no damage. That's our downfall right there. Now it's getting scary. Now I think he's gonna take us out. So go for the Flamethrower. He's gonna Morning Sun again? Really? Okay, I mean, I guess. That's kinda questionable, I'd say. Kinda questionable. Took him out where he was before. He could have easily taken us out there. He is faster and has the Calm Minds. I guess he wants more opportunity to set up Calm Minds. But at this point, Morning Sun's not doing anything. And he's just kind of waiting for us to get paralyzed or get a crit or something. Yeah, I guess he is waiting for us to get paralyzed. That would make the most sense. Yeah. He's going to run out of Morning Suns. How much does he get? Like 10? 5? I feel like he only gets 5. But he might have max PP. We're going to get paralyzed, and there we go. He gets what he wants. Now he's going to take us out, right? Now he's going to take us out. Okay. Just go for Flamethrower again. No reason not to. He's gonna get for stored power. Ouch. That's scary. That's definitely scary. The thing is, I don't think that can really hurt Solrock. Especially if we get our own stat boosts, which I'm gonna go for. I'm gonna go for that. Let's go for Solrock. I wanna set up a Cosmic Power. I want to set up a Cosmic Power. He might go for Calm Mind here, but I don't think he can hit us very hard. Not at all. What are you going to do, dude? He might be fearing the Explosion or something, too. Like, you never know. Solrox, I think, usually run Explosion. This one does not have it. He's going to for Dazzling Gleam, which is going to do a good amount of damage, I think. Is that going to screw us over? Oh, it is. Damn, that sucks. I think the game might be over at this point. I don't think we really have a chance. But we're gonna get our special defense and defense rose. Which could come in handy. I don't know at this point. Scary. He might take the opportunity to go set up his own Morning Sun again, because he is kind of running low with the... No, he's gonna Dazzling Gleam again. I think that'll take us out. Ooh, made a bad play there. That's my fault. I'll take my own responsibility for that. That's okay, though. We can go ahead and go into our Heliolisk now. Hit him hard with some nice special attacks. Thing is, Store Power might take us out. I do not know. Now, what's going to do more, Hyper Voice or Thunderbolt? I forget the base power. The check moves, it says that Thunderbolt has nice and 90, Hyper Voice has nice and 90. Okay. Well, we'll go for Hyper Voice because I like the animation. Both are stab. Let's see how it goes. He's gonna go for the story power. Can we live it? That'd be amazing if we live it. We don't. Alright. So that's gonna be the second battle, guys. Unfortunately, we'll go down to this Espeon. It was a really nice setup that he did, so that's awesome. But I'll see you guys in battle number 3. Alrighty, guys, we're hopping into the third battle with the Sun team to see if it's gonna move on. Or no, this is the last battle no matter what. We have Crimson from Indiana, the United States. Our first American opponent. He's got a Milotic, a Megalopunny, Talonflame, which is scary. I think, obviously, Charizard's gonna be the lead. We'll bring Solrock once again, and this time I wanna bring something different. I can bring Espeon or Ninetales. Which one does more work? I think Espeon. Espeon can obviously hit the, We'll bring Espeon. Let's just do it. Let's do it, guys. Let's see how this goes. Hopefully, we'll be able to bring out the W, am I right? Alright, Crimson, let's go, man. Let's go. Maybe our Mega Charizard will sweep. Who knows? Is he gonna lead with... Is he gonna lead with his Lopunny? He's gonna lead with his Talonflame. It's like the worst possible thing for him to lead with. Kind of. I'm gonna switch into Solrock. Yeah. Solrock. He's gonna go for the U-turn. Oh no! Is that super effective? Yeah, it is. What the heck? Ouch. Ooh, that messed us up too. I didn't realize that was super effective. Or no, I realized it was super effective, but I thought he would stay in and go for the Brave Bird. Alright, what's he gonna do now? Can Solrock bring us the W? Remember, guys, these teams actually aren't built competitively. I am a competitive battler. That's for my battling series, my Wi-Fi battle series. This is just for fun battles on BattleSpot with theme teams. These teams aren't like competitively made to cover each other's weaknesses. There's no tiers. Obviously, we're on rated BattleSpot. So, you know, don't get too salty if I do pretty bad in these. What's he gonna go into? Come on, Crimson. You don't need to take all day, dude. Come on, if it takes too long, I'll speed it up. Alright, no, he's gonna send in Garchomp. Every single time I say I'll speed it up, it all of a sudden goes immediately. But yeah, whatever. That's cool. We have the lefties. I guess he can. Does Fink can, like, Earthquake? I don't know, I'll go for Will-O-Wisp. That'll shut him down. Mega Evolve. And if we shut him down, we can go for Stealth Rocks too, which will help us out against the Talonflame a ton. A ton! Swords Dance. Ah, well. Hate to rain on your parade, buddy. Bam. Now we get a free turn to set up rocks, too. Okay, free turn to set up rocks. He gets out of more Swords Dances, but basically, what it comes down to is he's taking damage every single turn. I know Charizard will be able to outspeed and hit him really hard with an Air Slash. Or even a, Air Slash has stab, so it might do more than Solar Beam, I think. Regardless, we can go for our Stealth Rock here. What's he gonna do? He's gonna go for another Swords Dance, of course. Makes sense. Makes sense. I would expect him to. Bringing him up to plus two. Our Stealth Rock's gonna go off. So now his Talonflame's kinda screwed, which is really good for us. Really good. I don't know if a Brave Bird will be able to take us out, too. At this point, I'll just... we're almost from full health. I don't think we'll be able to eat a hit, crunch or anything. I'll just go for a Rock Slide. Why not? We're Levitate. Oh no, I feel so bad, dude. We're Levitate, man. Obviously, this isn't gonna do much damage. It is resisted, but that's, you know, a pretty decent amount. Not gonna lie. Not gonna lie at all. We get our lefties recovery, which is cool. Bringing us up to 131 HP. That's nice. Meanwhile, he's almost at below half because of his little blunder right there. He's gonna go for a Dragon Claw. I think that'll take us out, right? Or nah. Or nah, Rock Slide. I was gonna avoid it. Oh well. But Solrock put in work twice. Like, really nice work. Good job, Solrock. I am proud of you. I am. I did not expect that at all. You know, I'd be really, really sad if... I think I'm gonna go for Solar Beam with the Charizard, just because... Like, what if Air Slash misses? And, like, he's at such a low amount of HP at this point. Really wouldn't be worth it. Really wouldn't be worth it at all. Yeah, we'll do that. go into our Charizard and set up the sun, which doesn't matter for us too much right now. Not at all, really. Alrighty. Mega Evolution, Solar Beam. It makes sense. It helps us with the Solar Beam. That's about it, though. So now his Talonflame's gonna be taking a ton of damage when it comes back in, too. So all we need to do is save our Charizard at full health, which we can use Roost, and the Talonflame will go down. But yeah, Solar Beam's gonna be able to take him down, right? Yeah, it's got it. Look how low he is. It can't. Nice, there we go. So his Mega is down, our Mega's at full health. His Talonflame is basically useless. He's gonna go into his Milotic. Now we still have the Solar Beam. I don't think he'll be able to kill necessarily, but his water attacks won't be able to do crap to us because of the sun. So I'm not afraid of going for another Solar Beam here. Absorbing in the light. What if Charizard just brings us down on lockdown? That'd be insane. And obviously we can't get burned too. Unfortunately, it's not going to be a one-hit KO. He's going to go for Scald. Again, yeah, not going to do too much in the rain at all. I almost want to go for the Roost here. To see if, I don't know, I don't want to waste the sun. We'll go for Solar Beam. Are we going to be able to eat a Brave Bird? That's what I'm afraid to know. Are we going to be able to eat a Brave Bird? He didn't go for Brave Bird turn 1, which I thought was really weird. Does he know Calcs? Does he know it really good? Does he know that he's not going to be able to take me out here? Or that he's going to be able to take me out? Okay, so... with the sun up, does... No. We'll go for Air Slash. Here comes the Brave Bird. Here comes the Brave Bird. I'm prepared to take it. 100% prepared. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Come on, guys. Clench. Let's see. Is it gonna take us out? I really hope not. And no. No. That sucks. Okay. We have a full health Espeon, which probably can't eat a Brave Bird. Probably not. Let's see how this goes. Also Psychic. No point in not. Bravebird's gonna go off. He's probably Choice Banded. Espeon's kind of frail. Yeah. Alright, guys, so the Sun team unfortunately made it out with a 1-2 record. Or. Wait a second. Did we? No, we lost. Okay. Yeah, we unfortunately made it out with a 1-2 record. Which sucks, but it's alright. We came really close to the last one, especially. So now we're gonna go ahead and move on to the Moon team, guys, so I will see you all then. And guys, here we go with the Moon team. Of course, we have Lunatone, Umbreon, Weavile, Nidoking, Nidoqueen, and Mega Salamence to kick off our team. Let's see how we do. Hopefully, we can pull out 2 wins from this one. We have a Japan player at 466. That's probably... our rating is 1488 at the moment. So he's got an Altaria, his own Salamence, oh god. He's got a lot of dragons, which makes me want to lead out with our Weavile. We'll bring Salamence in the back, of course, and then... Alright, what will help out? What can we not hit very hard? We cannot hit the Tyranitar really hard. So I think I'm gonna bring Nidoking. Nidoking's just very versatile and good. So yeah, we'll do that. Those will be our 3 Pokemon for this battle. Let's go ahead and see what he's got for us. That little Zoom Reel's kinda scary as well. Who knows how good we'll do against it. Alrighty. Go ahead and tell me in the comment section, guys, what's your favorite TV show? I want to know your favorite TV show. My favorite TV show, personally, I always like Futurama. I think Futurama is hilarious, actually. It's a really good show. If you guys haven't watched it, check it out. It's on Netflix. I've seen every episode, probably like twice at least, if not more. It's a really good show. I love it. I like to watch it like at night when I'm just like falling asleep. Anyways, guys, if this guy's like timer stalling or whatever, I'll go ahead and fast forward to when he is done. But if not, hi guys, how you doing? This is like Demi did that this time. He didn't start, so I don't know. Oh, yes he did. I lied. Okay. That's cool. Luke versus Jip. I think this guy's Japanese, right? I don't know. Anyways, he's gonna send out for us. What's he got? He's gonna start out with his... the worst thing he could have started out with. That's cool. Okay, Weavile. Do we have Fake Out?
We have... Do we have poison jabs? I think he probably's gonna like belly drum or some crap. Watch us catch him off guard here. I don't think he expects... Yo, Wifi coming through. Almost taking him out in one turn. Please belly drum, I dare you. Citrus berry, ouch. That's still pretty scary, actually. Ugh. Belly drum failed, awesome. Which means we can hit him with another poison jab right here. That's awesome. Aqua Jet, I don't think it's going to take us out. I really don't. Yep, not even close. Poison Jet coming through. Bam, dude. You're out of here. That's why you don't set up on the first turn ever, unless you have, like, some really, really super, like, obvious play. We're going to lose some HP from our Life Orb that we have. That's okay by me, though. That is okay by me. Guys, I'm really excited because I got an Omega Racing chair, and it's coming in soon. I can get rid of... If you guys haven't seen my chair, it's actually a piece of crap. I swear it's from, like, the 80s. That's how old it is. Okay, so he's going to Mega Evolve to a Fairy-type, right? Right? Or do we straight up go for Icicle Crash? Either way, let's go for Icicle Crash. Let's do it, man. Oh my god, that's a dead Altaria! That's a dead Altaria right there, guys! Bam! We've all coming through. Look at all that power. Look at all that amazing power we've all has. Again, we're starting to go down a little bit, or a lot of bit, really. But if he has the Salamence, right? Oh, this thing. Okay. I wonder if it's Scarfed. We'll find out. Also, Icicle Crash again. If he outspeeds, yeah, he outspeeds. So that means he is Scarfed. I don't know why he would Scarf himself into that attack out of all attacks. Why not Dragon Attack for our Salamence that we have? That's clearly going to destroy him right here. Actually, but little does he know, our Salamence doesn't have a Dragon-type attack. We have Earthquake, Roost. I could be completely wrong, but from what I know, we have Earthquake, Roost, Return, and Dragon Dance. I'm going to go for the Ice Beam here. No reason not to. I have Choice Scarf Stealth Rocks on this set. That's fun. That's going to do a ton of damage, but not enough to take us out. Ice Beam's coming off. Bam! That should be a KO. There we go. Oko on this thing. Critical hit. I don't think it mattered, but it might have. Who knows? It might have. So that's going to be the first battle, guys. We get a nice 2-0 on this guy. That's awesome. That's awesome. So I'll go ahead and see you guys for battle number 2 with the Moon Theme Team. Alright, guys. We're looking for our next opponent now. Who's it going to be? Who's ready to be our next victim that we're going to take down? Who is it going to be? We got Naru from Japan, of course. With a 1-4-8-8 record. Our record is 15-0-3 at the moment. We're staying positive. We are staying positive. His team looks pretty good. It's probably a Mario Charizard X. I kind of honestly want to lead with the Salamence this time. Or we could lead with Weavile. You know, Weavile does good against all these teams. Oh my lord. Yeah, we'll lead with Weavile. In the back, we'll bring Salamence, of course. And, I kind of want to bring... What does Nidoqueen have? What's the Nidoqueen set? Ice Beam, Earth Power, Roar, Toxic Spikes. I feel like that's not too helpful against this team. Something that I'm kind of afraid about is that Ferrothorn. Our Lunatone. Okay, I'm gonna bring Lunatone. I'm bringing Lunatone in the back. See if we can get some setups for our thingy. Setups for our Salamence. Get it some speed with Rock Polish and Baton Pass. We're just waiting for this guy to pick his Pokemon now. I think he's going to lead with a Dragon-type, hopefully. I don't know, man. Probably the... I feel like he's going to lead with... Possibly that Volt Switcher. That's a possibility, too. I don't know. We'll see. Alright, here we go, guys. Here we go. Naru. That's probably pronounced so differently in Japanese. I have no idea, man. He's going to send out his... What's it going to be? What's it going to be? Alright, Charizard, I'm not too afraid of that. Yes, I am, that's a fire type, and we're an ice type. But at the same time, I'm not switching into anything. Because we're probably faster, and it's definitely mega. I'm gonna Icicle Crash. Either way, it should do neutral damage, no matter what mega it is. We should be faster, right? Should be, at least turn one. What are you gonna do, dude? 1500 link battles, oh my lord. Are you evolving into Y? Alright, that's what I thought. That's cool. Not too afraid. Drought's gonna go up. That's cool. Doesn't affect us really at all. I'm going for Icicle Crest, which is going to do a good amount of damage, I assume. Charizard-wise, pretty frail. Definitely not going to take him out. Unless we get, like, a crit or something. Which we don't. He's probably going to take us out with the overheat. Miss? No, okay. Well, his special attack is lowered, which... That's why overheat's not that good. I mean, it does a ton of damage. Crit didn't matter, definitely. I want to take this opportunity that we have here to go into Lunatone. I'm going to take this opportunity to go into Lunatone. See what this Lunatone does that's pretty amazing is... has Calm Mind, it has Rock Polish. It does not have Baton Pass, I forgot. I guess I got rid of it, damn. Okay, that's not scary. Calm Mind and then Psychic, maybe? It was the old one that had Baton Pass. He's gonna go into his Magnezone. Okay. It's not Air Balloon. What does he have, like Flash Cannon? We should be able to eat one of those. Alright, so. Earth Power, here we go. We got speed. Nice. That should be a Oko. There we go. Lunatone and Solrock have put in so much work. That is so unexpected. Guys, Mega Solrock and Lunatone are basically like confirmed. Like, let's be honest, right? They seem so obvious. His Intimidate's gonna go off. That doesn't faze me at all whatsoever. He can probably kill us with a Waterfall, though, unfortunately. So what I'm gonna do is... I'm gonna Rock Polish so we can outspeed him next turn. Because I have Focus Sash. And we already outspeed. I could've gone for a Calm Mind. Oh my god. Aqua Tail. I mean, we're also in the sun, too. Okay, but still. Man, that sucks that we already outsped. I didn't know this thing had good speed, oh my lord. Watch us get a crit or something and his Aqua Tail misses. And then we can outspeed his Charizard. I would die. Oh my god! We got a crit! I was going for Earthquake. We have Levitate! Oh my god, did we just get a Lunatone sweep on Battle Spot? I feel like we just did. I feel like we just did. That's insane. Lunatone of all Pokemon. No way. I think we can definitely finish off his Charizard with a Psychic. Can we outspeed after one Rock Polish? Ooh, that's kinda risky. I mean, if we outspeed a Gyarados and a Magnezone. I don't know, we'll see. We get the outspeed! Psychic's going off! Oh, that was amazing. That's two wins for the Moon Team, guys. That's going to be the end of the episode. I hope you all enjoyed it. Remember, if you want this series to continue, leave a like, tell me you liked it, and leave your suggestions for the next themed battle in the comment section below. And with that, guys, my name is Luke, aka the Beast Pokeballer. And have a nice day, guys. Now let the outro roll!